A new piece of the puzzle tonight. What has long been speculated in the death of Phylicia Barnes is now confirmed. Her death ruled a homicide, but there are still more questions than answers. Authorities released the autopsy results today, but they're giving few details on the teenager's killing.
The announcement comes as Phylicia Barnes' family receives her body and prepares for her funeral. 11 News reporter Sheldon Dutes is live at State Police headquarters. He has the very latest, Sheldon.
No suspects or persons of interest have been identified, but state police are confident that this new piece of information will help them move the case forward.
The puzzle pieces in the mysterious disappearance of Phylicia Barnes are slowly starting to come together.
I think each additional bit of information is helping investigators, and they're using that as effectively as they can.
When Phylicia's body was pulled from the raging waters of the Susquehanna River 2 weeks ago, there were no obvious signs of trauma, but an autopsy has ruled that the 16-year-old honor student was murdered. Authorities, however, will not say how she was killed, though.
There's certain information in investigations that sometimes is only known by the person or persons responsible for committing that crime, and that's an important tool for investigators to use, both in determining who was responsible and ultimately in the prosecution of the case.
Originally from North Carolina, Phylicia was visiting relatives in Baltimore over Christmas break. She was last seen on December 28th at an apartment on Eberly Drive in Northwest Baltimore. It's the same spot where her family gathered for a candlelight vigil last week. Her case has long been pursued as foul play, so the official ruling of her death was not a surprise to those involved.
I don't think it comes as a surprise to anyone, including the family, but it certainly doesn't come as a surprise to investigators. The Baltimore Police Department has covered this as if it were a homicide from the beginning, and that's why they've, you know, been very detailed in their investigation, very thorough.
If you have any information that can help investigators, contact state police or the city homicide department. A private funeral will be held in Barnes' honor this weekend in Atlanta. Her family wants to have a public memorial for her here in Baltimore the weekend afterward. We're live tonight in Parksville. Sheldon Dutes, WBAL-TV 11 News.